everybody. Welcome to Playdough on the Porch with Deborah
and Rochelle.
Now, before we started, we both washed our hands for 20 seconds under the tap and we sang happy birthday to you. All right, now we're gonna make our Playdough. So in order to make Playdough, you need 2 cups of flour. We put 1 cup in already and now we're adding the other cup. Oops, it's a little messy. Next, we have to add our food coloring to our cup of water. Rochelle, can you do that? We need to add 2 drops. 1, 2. Then we have our 1 cup of salt. In it goes to the water. And we can mix it up. By mixing it, the salt dissolves a little bit. All right. Next, we need a tablespoon of oil. Rochelle, can you get the tablespoon of oil ready?
Yes, I can.
Right.
There we go.
Gotta scrape out a bit more of my salt. All right, as soon as we get all of our ingredients all in, we're gonna mix it with our hands. Good thing they're clean. Voila. Is it ooky and gooky?
Yeah.
Oh, nice mixing, Rochelle. So we're going to try to mix it until it's a pretty even texture. And then we're going to divide it into 2 balls because we're going to be showing you guys some fun activities that we can do with Playdough. Mixing. If you want it to be a brighter color, you can add more food coloring. Sorry, this is a pretty pale color.
You want to add some more?
I think I'll just help you finish mixing. Ours is like a pale green, I'd say. There we go. Okay, so let's move aside all of our cooking supplies.
And bring it.
All right, so we're gonna break our Play-Doh into 2 so we can demonstrate 2 different things. First, Rochelle, let's do a snake first. I'm going to roll my snake on the table. All right. There. Let's show first pennies, putting pennies in. Would you like to show that, Rochelle?
Sure.
Or we both show? Both show? All right, I'm doing pick up and hide, like we do at school, everybody. Alright, then I wiggle them to my fingertips and I put them in my snake. Ooh, you got lots, Rochelle. Wow, look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nice job. And we can also pull them out. All right, next let's make a cookie shape. So you make a ball in between your hands, and then you flatten it on the table. Now, what can we do with our cookie? Well, we can use our same pennies again, and we could make a chocolate chip cookie. Nice cookie. Or, if you have googly eyes at home, you can make a crazy monster by adding in your different googly eyes all over your circle. Let's show it. Ooh. All right, so we have to remove those a little bit quickly. And then we're gonna show a porcupine. Oh, so I might keep two eyeballs handy so I can put eyeballs in my porcupine. D Penny. Alright, then we're gonna make a ball again. Alright, so you can make an animal shape if you want, or you can just leave it as a ball. It's up to you. I think I'm gonna do an animal shape for mine. With a bit of a head. And in go my two eyes. All right, next we're gonna make porcupines. Now, our porcupines can be made with toothpicks, or we ran out of toothpicks, so we have skewers. So it's gonna be a pretty crazy porcupine with long, long spikes on his back. Voila. Hello.
Hi.
All right, a few more activities we're gonna show you guys. And eyeballs out. Okay, next we're gonna show how you pinch and roll little balls in one hand. Okay, watch. I pinch and then I use my hand muscles to try, oh, Rochelle, your ball's a bit too big. To make little balls. So we can call them eggs, we can call them, what else can we call them? Food, pretend they're marshmallows. See how many balls that you can make before your hand gets tired. One hand, Rochelle. Okay, I'm gonna make one more ball. Now, another thing we could do when we're pinching is we could pinch off and make a letter shape. So I'm going to move my balls to the side. There. All right. So my letter shape is going to be D for Deborah. So I'm going to pinch off pieces and put them in a row. So first I do my big line down. Then I do my big curve. So you can attach your pieces together like Rochelle's doing, or you can keep your pieces separate like I'm doing. Now Rochelle has an R, so she's doing big line down, little curve, and little line. Voila! I have my D, and Rochelle has her R. We did a great job, and we had lots of different fun things we did. Oh, one last little game that you could also do is if you have your scissors, you could snip your Play-Doh into little pieces as well. Like that. Well, I hope you enjoyed Play-Doh on the Porch and hope to see you guys again soon. Bye for now.